Okay, we're going to give everyone their own personal assistant using Claude, and something you can actually set up in less than 10 minutes and really showcases the power of Claude's projects feature. So who doesn't want their own personal assistant? That would be awesome. So let's share this. But I'm going to go through the entire workflow again. And so I'm going to show you how to do this via a Claude Enterprise seat, but you can do the exact same thing on a personal plan. The only reason I'm calling that out is there's a couple of additional features that I have that you'll see, and I'll tell you how you can do it if you don't have an Enterprise seat. Plus, this is brand new, so it's set up with dummy data. I'm only starting to set up the Enterprise seat now. So the first thing you want to do is go to Projects. Projects is one of the best features launched last year. Not enough people are using it, so we're going to change that. You can see, think of Projects as an AI assistant tasked with a singular thing, in this case, to be my executive assistant. And so the reason I say that is you can basically set up a project and then you can give it some actual instructions, and those instructions last across all of the different chats you have, right? So in this case, we want our personal assistant to be able to do a bunch of our meet analysis. We're going to give it all of the meeting transcripts after every singular meeting. It's going to do all of our follow-up management. So it's going to coordinate all of our different projects and follow-ups and make sure we stay on top of all of that. It's going to have a communication style, and we give it the output format. So we tell it like what we want in terms of the output format, and when it's doing meeting summaries, when it's doing follow-ups, when it's actually drafting replies for me. And then for follow-up tracking, we talk about the outstanding items. I want what's due this week, what's overdue, what are suggested messages. So this one here, I'm actually going to tweak. I can show you why. This one here, it's fine. It can definitely be improved upon. So you want to give it some instructions. Then the cool thing is about projects is I can basically add content really easily. So in my case, the reason I call it the Enterprise seat, I'm very lucky because I can just search in my G Drive. It connects into a bunch of apps. So I've given it this project file, which is this. So this is just a flat file, right? Basically, it's going to capture all of the follow-ups, and this is dummy content here. But what I'm giving it is the actual structure that I want to maintain. And you'll see Claude actually starts to keep that list itself. So it's going to keep the follow-ups and update it itself. And then you want to provide the meeting summary. So if you're on a personal plan, you would upload these documents. I can just connect into my doc, and basically I can just go and say, look, where are the meeting summaries, and I can find them all. And so I've added like one with dummy data, because obviously there's a bunch of like personal things in here or business things in here. So now I've set up my assistant. I will show you the chat I had, but I can go through all of the things I did, right? So give you some ideas. So now we can basically ask it to analyze the latest meeting transcript and update our action list, right? So when you upload a meeting, now I probably would do this at the end of each day versus after every singular meeting, but I do use it for after meetings as well, because it just give me the meeting summary, and I can basically ask it to draft that meeting summary into a bullet point list to actually provide people with the follow-ups, gives you the key decisions, and then it talks about the action items. So this is the really cool bit, right? It actually extracts the action items and starts to talk about what they are. And then combines them with the existing tracked items. And I'll show you what that means. It does flag things. It generally will flag things based upon timelines, which I think is really good. Now, this is what I said. It will go into the things I asked, right? It will start to flag. This was in the last bit of the instructions I give it, which is tell us about the existing, what else is like in that follow-up list, and then actually suggest some follow-ups. Now, I actually don't want it to do follow-ups until I ask, so I would stop it doing that, which is just an adjustment in the prompt. So basically, analyze the meeting, and then I say, well, what are our stand-up action items, and what needs to follow up today? So I start my morning with Claude. It can pull from that list and basically tell me, like, what are the urgent things I need to do today? What is the context? What is the history? How dope is that, right? I get my own, like, what is my to-do list today? Look, people keep saying AI is killing search, but that's not the full story. If you know how to use it to your advantage, AI can actually help you win. Search has been a huge part of HubSpot's success story, and we are actually excited to figure out how we can integrate AI into our organic strategy to make things even better. HubSpot has just dropped a guide that will help you navigate search in the AI era with AI-powered SEO tools, techniques for content optimization, and future-proofing techniques to stay ahead of the evolving algorithm. Get it right now at the link in the description. Now back to the show. Now imagine you actually have this across all of your projects, right? I've just got dummy data in here, but I'm going to actually use it for, I have three large pods that I manage within HubSpot, and I'm going to have an EA assistant for each one. And each one will be able to tell me what are the core things I need to do that day with context. across those three different pods. So it will basically give me what are the urgent tasks, and then it will say what are the recommended immediate follow-ups and call out the people. Then I ask it for the complete list of action. This is with the cool bit, right? So give, what are all the follow-ups I actually have on the list, on the docket right now? So the first time it basically goes through, it tells me what they all are. Again, this is all dummy data. Tells me what is due this week. They don't actually have due dates. I actually need to put due dates. So the thing is, you really need to stick to that format. And I think that's a good thing because it really forces you to make sure that there's an owner description, due date, and when you actually have that thing delivered. So it suggests next steps. And then I ask for the table format. So you can see it didn't give me the table format. I actually prefer a table format. And here it gives me the table format. So it will continue to update that for you. And when you say there's a one of those is complete, it will actually take it off. So it will keep a running order of that list for you at all times, which is amazing. And then it will start to draft. So like I have different prompts. This one here is if I want to get a confirmation on a status, right? This is progress check. So I'll basically say, hey, like draft a follow-up for me on the thing that we talked about, the LTV to CAC, and basically ask, you know, gives it some guidance in what to do here. And so it will actually draft me that, like just cut and paste and then send. I can actually, in the instructions I give to my EA, I'm going to actually ask it to either give me an email or a Slack, depending on what I ask, because the Slack one should be much, much shorter. So I actually have that done on my personal. I actually need to incorporate it into the enterprise seat. So you can basically say, you can set one from email, you can set one for Slack, you can set whatever you want to do. Now, you're probably looking and saying, well, I want to get all of the instructions that Kieran's showing us. I can't provide the docs along with this video on LinkedIn where I'm going to post it, or even on YouTube if we post it there. I will give them to you in my newsletter. So I'm going to send this video next week to my newsletter subscribers. You can find it on my LinkedIn profile. And I'll send you all of the docs that I used here, basically the instructions that I give, the exact instructions that I give my EA. So basically it gives the follow-up here. There's another one here, which is basically, this is assigning a task. So basically I want to clearly state that this person owns this task and when the deadline is, and ask for confirmation that they understand that. So you can see here again, this one here is for checking in. This one here is for making sure we've assigned all tasks. And then basically I've assigned this task out. So I actually give this as a new task with a new due date. And then it will update that list. So it updates the list here. First, I'll try. Yeah, this here. So required follow-ups, and it's added here, Jan 10th, right? So it's actually added that list. So basically, what is it doing, right? It's basically capturing, what are we doing? We're setting some instructions for this AI assistant on how it should act across all of this chat, and it keeps that context. Then we're just adding all of our meeting transcripts. So after every single meeting, we just add the transcript and it can provide a summary of the meeting, and it can extract all follow-up actions. And then we provided guidelines on what we want those follow-up actions to, like what format to keep those follow-up actions in. And it keeps a running list of that. So you can go back to your assistant and say, okay, like what is the list? What's due this week? What's due today? Actually, we did this one. So can you put this off the list? Actually, can you draft a follow-up to Kieran? And basically the prompts I showed you, this is a check-in. Check-in this, give me a status, like, or I want to assign this one out. Can you draft that? And we'll draft it in the right format, and then we'll add it to the list for you. Now you can go way, way deeper on this. I'm giving you the quick thing you can set up in over the weekend and have it ready for next week, and really just showing you how you should really think about projects and play around with projects. Claude will, I guarantee, Claude in their enterprise version will plug into Google Docs and allow you to write back into that file. So for the moment, it's keeping a running list for you in the Claude assistant. But if you go back into the doc, it's not updating the doc. You'd have to copy and paste the table I showed you back into the doc if you want to share that with other folks. So that is a bit of a challenge, because you probably want to share that doc with your team or have a running doc that's being uploaded. All of your team can see it. That will come. I'm pretty sure that will come from Claude, that they'll be able to write back into docs. At the moment, you cannot do that. You could just read from those docs. The other thing that we'll be able to do, I think, in the future is like draft these emails for you in your email client and then actually draft them for you in Slack. I think that will come as well, and actually be able to like plug it into your Slack to actually keep track of your comms there as well. So there's a bunch of things that I think will probably come from Claude, like basically a knowledge assistant, right? So you'll be able to like start creating these projects and plug into a bunch of different tools. But for me, this is a pretty great step one, that if you can get that set up over the weekend and you have those per project, you can create one for all of your projects if you don't have a lot of things going on. But if you have like hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people that you're kind of managing across different projects, I think an EA assistant per project works really, really well. So that is the Claude EA assistant and a little bit of like why I think projects is such an underutilized tool, but such an incredible tool. Let me know in the comments if you found it useful, and also tell me if there's other use cases that you're interested in solving with Claude.
This data is wrong every freaking time.
Have you heard of HubSpot? HubSpot is a CRM platform where everything is fully integrated.
Whoa, I can see the client's whole history. Calls, support tickets, emails, and here's a task from 3 days ago I totally missed.
HubSpot, grow better.